Hello and welcome back. In this action-packed video, we are going to back up the PowerProtect DD Management Center itself, then delete it from vCenter. We'll then redeploy the DDMC with the same name that it had before and restore its contents from backup. Before we start, there are two prerequisites for making all of this happen. First, we need a dedicated mTree in place for storing the DR backup on one of the data domain systems that the DDMC manages. We also need to create an NFS export for the mTree and to provide the DDMC with full access to it. Please note that the Smart Scale feature is available starting in DDMC 7.8. With that in mind, let's get started. Open a web browser and log into the PowerProtect Data Domain Management Center GUI with sysadmin credentials. Navigate to Infrastructure, then Systems. A reminder that in this video, we are using Data Domain Virtual Edition systems, but in production, this feature is only supported in models DD6900, 9400, and 9900. There are two DDs that are managed by this DDMC. Of these two, we know that DDVE2 contains the mobile storage unit we've already created for backup, so select it, then click View DD System Manager. In the left pane, under Data Management, select mTree to create a new mTree. Specify a name for the mTree, then click OK. Now, let's move on to NFS under Protocols. Click Create to create an NFS export for the mTree we just created. Under Clients, click the plus sign circle to add a client in order to provide the DDMC with full access to this NFS export. Click OK. Verify that the client is now listed on the Create NFS Export screen, then click OK to complete the NFS export and return to the DDMC GUI. Both the prerequisites are now done. Now we will configure the DR backup by selecting Settings, then Disaster Recovery. On the Configuration tab, select the DD name and the NFS export path that we just created, then click Apply. As soon as the configuration is complete, the backup kicks in, and by default, it runs every 15 minutes. When the DR backup is complete, we'll use it to recover the DDMC. Click Close. Now we'll create some mayhem. Log into the vCenter where the DDMC resides, power off the VM, and delete it from the disk. And now for the recovery. It starts by deploying the brand new DDMC of the same version. This video doesn't cover the initial configuration of DDMC after the OVF is deployed. We'll quickly enter the information required to deploy the OVF here, such as hostname and IP. The entire process takes around 20 minutes. Log in to DDMC with sysadmin credentials. This is the new DDMC, and we can see that it doesn't yet have any DD systems to manage. Under Settings, select Restore DDMC to start the recovery. Enter the passphrase, then confirm it. Specify the DD system where the dedicated mTree was created to receive the DDMC DR backup and the NFS export path. By default, the latest readable backup file is available to recover. Click Next, review the summary information, then click Restore to begin the recovery. When the recovery is complete, DDMC reboots automatically. When the system is back online, log in to the DDMC GUI. With relief, we can now see, under Infrastructure, then Systems, that the custom dashboard and the two DD systems we had before are fully recovered. Thanks for watching.